Who's there?
Hold on.
Must have something to do with it.
Yes, these are Akaviri symbols. Here, let's see. You have the symbol for king and warrior, and of course the symbol for dragonborn. That's the one that appears to have a sort of arrow shape pointing downward at the bottom. Yes, that's it. Symbol on the pillar on the left.
Whatever you did, you worked. Let's see what those old blades look like.
Fuck it up, please.
Wait.
Why are you stopping?
We should be careful here. See these symbols on the floor?
Esbern's right. Look like pressure plates.
Be careful.
Look safe now. Let's move.
We must be close to the end.
Remarkably well preserved. Here's the blood seal, another of the lost Akaviri arts, no doubt triggered by, well, blood. Your blood.
Try dripping blood on
you
the
You see how the ancient blades revered me in Cyrodiil? This whole place appears to be a shrine.
Help drawing some blood.
The end of the Akaviri invasion under mysterious circumstances, you recall? Amazing.
The Akaviri blood seal can only be opened with the right kind of blood. Your blood, Dragonborn.
Goodbye, then.
Alduin isn't getting any weaker while we... The faction that rules the Aldmeri Dominion. There's no worse enemy to humankind in Tavriel. The Empire barely survived the last war.
After the so-called Battle of Pale Pass, Akaviri went into the service. This was the foundation stone of the Second Empire.
If you need help drawing some blood, let me know.
For you guys, how am I supposed to draw my own blood?
Try dripping blood onto the carving on the floor.
Oh, just activate. Oh. Touché.
It's coming to life. After you, Dragon, you should have the honor of being the first to separate this.
There's no telling what we might find inside.
Yes. All right, let's see what you have.
Yes. We'll have more time to look around later, I suppose. Let's see what's up ahead. Shaw's bones, here it is. Alduin's wall, so well preserved. I've never seen a final example of early Second Era Akaviri sculpture in relief.
Hesper, we need information, not a lecture on
artists. Yes, let's see what we have. Here, the humans rebel against their dragon overlord, the legendary dragon war. Alduin's defeat is the centerpiece of the war. You see, here is fallen from the sky, the Nord Tongs, masters of the voice, are arrayed against them.
So does it show how they defeated him? Isn't that why we're here?
Ah, patient. The Akaviri were not a straightforward people. Everything is cast in hand. Mythic symbol. Yes, then. This here, coming from the mouths of the Nord heroes, this is the Akaviri symbol for shout, but there's no way to know what shout is meant.
You mean they used a shout to defeat Alduin? You're sure?
Oh, yes. Presumably something rather specific to dragons, or even Alduin himself. remember. This is where they recorded all they knew of Aldrin.
So we're looking for a shout then. Damn it. Have you ever heard of such a thing? A shout that can knock a dragon out of the sky? You're probably right. I was hoping to avoid having to involve them in this, but it seems we have no choice. If they had their way, you do nothing but sit up on their mountain with them and talk to the sky or whatever it is they do. The Greybeards are so afraid of power that they won't use it. Think about it. Have they tried to stop the Civil War or done anything about Alduin? No. And they're afraid of you, of your power. Trust me, there is no need to be afraid. Think of Tiber Septim. Do you think he'd have founded the Empire if he'd listened to the Greybeards? Only if you don't know how to use it. All the great heroes have had to learn to use their power. Those that shrank from their destiny. Well, you've never heard of them, have you? And there are the villains, those that misused their power. There's always a choice, and there's always a risk. But if you live in fear of what might go wrong, you'll end up doing nothing. Like the Greybeards up on their mountain. Right. Good thing they've already let you into their little cult. Not likely they'd help Esbern or me if we came calling. We'll look around Skyhaven Temple and see what else the old Blades might have left for us. It's a better hideout than I could have hoped for. Talos guard you.
Look here, in the third panel. The prophecy which brought the Akaviri to Tamriel in the first place, in search of the Dragonborn. Here are the Akaviri, the Blades. You see their distinctive long swords. Now they need their ancient mission fulfilled as the last Dragonborn contends with Aldrin at the end of time. Are you paying attention, Delphine? You might learn something of our own history. You say something? You'll have to speak up. I'm a little deaf in my right ear. Thank you.
Sky above, voice within. Where did you learn of that? Who have you been talking to? The Blades, of course. They specialize in meddling in matters they barely understand. Their reckless arrogance knows no bounds. They have always sought to turn the Dragonborn from the path of wisdom. Have you learned nothing from us? Would you simply be a tool in the hands of the Blades to be used for their own purposes? No, no, of course not. Forgive me, Dragonborn. I have been intemperate with you. But heed my warning. The Blades may say they serve the Dragonborn, but they do not. They never have. No, I cannot teach it to you, because I do not know it. It is called Dragonrend, but its words of power are unknown to us. We do not regret this loss. Dragonrend holds no place within the way of the voice. It was created by those who had lived under the unimaginable cruelty of Alduin's dragon cult. Their whole lives were consumed with hatred for dragons, and they poured all their anger and hatred into this shout. When you learn a shout, you take it into your very being. In a sense, you become the shout. In order to learn and use this shout, you will be taking this evil into yourself. But not Dragonrend. The knowledge of that shout was lost in the time before history began. Perhaps only its creators ever knew it, but I am not the one to speak of it to you. Only Parthenax, the master of our order, can answer that question, if he so chooses. He is our leader. He surpasses us all in his mastery of the way of the voice. You weren't ready, you still aren't ready. But, thanks to the Blades, you now have questions that only Parthenax can answer. He lives in seclusion on the very peak of the mountain. He speaks to us only rarely, and never to outsiders. Being allowed to see him is a great privilege. Only those whose voice is strong can find the path. We will teach you a shout to open the way to Parthenax. The path to Parthenax lies through this gate. I will show you how to open the way.
Look.
grant you my understanding of clear skies. This is your final gift from us, Dragonborn. Use it well. Keep moving, stay focused on your goal, and you will reach the summit.
The wrong one.
Thank you. Dremyolok, greetings, Wundunik. I am Parthenax. Who are you? What brings you to my Strunmach, my mountain? They see me as master, Wuth Onik. Old and wise. It is true I am old. Tell me, why do you come here, Volan? Why do you intrude on my meditation? Drem, patience. There are formalities which must be observed at the first meeting of two of the Dove. By long tradition, the elder speaks first. Hear my thum. Feel it in your bones. Match it if you are Dovahkiin. mortal, but as Dovah. Of speech with one of my own kind. Ah, I have expected you, Proda. You would not come all this way for Tinvok with an old Dovah. No, you seek your weapon against Alduin. They are very protective of me, Bahlan Fadon. But I do not know the Thum you seek. Krosis, it cannot be known to me. Your kind, Jor, mortals, created it as a weapon against the Dove, the dragons. Our Hadrime, our minds cannot even comprehend its concepts. Drem, all in good time. First, a question for you. Why do you want to learn this, Thum? Pruza has good a reason as any. There are many who feel as you do, although not all. Some would say that all things must end so that the next can come to pass. Perhaps this world is simply the egg of the next Kalpa, Lin Vokin. Would you stop the next world from being born? Pause. A fair answer. Rofus, maybe you only balance the forces that work to quicken the end of this world. Even we who ride the currents of time cannot see past time's end. Wulsetid los Trahodis. Those who try to hasten the end may delay it. Those who work to delay the end may bring it closer. But you have indulged my weakness for speech long enough. Krosis, now I will answer your question. Do you know why I live here, at the peak of the Monaven, what you name Throat of the World? True, but few now remember that this was the very spot where Alduin was defeated by the ancient tongues. Varucht Unslad. Perhaps none but me now remember how he was defeated. Yes and no. Viknus Nikron. Alduin was not truly defeated either. If he was, you would not be here today seeking to defeat him. The Nords of those days used the Dragonrend shout to cripple Alduin, but this was not enough. Ok Mulag Unslad. It was the Kel, the Elder Scroll. They used it to cast him adrift on the currents of time. Mm, Not intentionally. Some hoped he would be gone forever. Forever lost. Meye. I knew better. Tidbo Amativ. Time flows ever onward. One day, he would surface. Which is why I have lived here. For thousands of mortal years, I have waited. I knew where he would emerge, but not when. Tid Krent, time was shattered here because of what the ancient Nords did to Alduin. If you brought that Kel, that Elder Scroll, back here to the Tid Ahran, the Time Wound, with the Elder Scroll that was used to break time, you may be able to cast yourself back to the other end of the break. You could learn Dragonrend from those who created it. You have it. The Kel, the Elder Scroll, Tidkrech Kalos. Time shudders at its touch. There is no question. You are doom-driven. Kolgan Akatosh. The very bones of the Earth are at your disposal. Go then. Fulfill your destiny. Take the scroll to the Time Wound. Do not delay. Alduin will be coming. He cannot miss the signs.
Hope we reach Ancestor Grade soon.
Today, Alduin's lordship will be restored. But I honor your courage, Krivolf Akrin. Die now in vain.
Glorious day, is it not? Have you no thought beyond the blooding of your blade?
What else is there?
Battle below goes ill. Faldun does not rise to our challenge. I fear all may be lost.
You worry too much, brother. Victory will be ours.
Why does Alduin hang back? We've staked everything on this plan of yours, old man.
He will come. He cannot ignore our defiance. And why should he fear us, even now?
We blooded him well. Four of his kin have fallen to my blade alone this day.
But none have yet stood against Alduin himself. Oh, sorry, Birkar.
They did not have Dragonrend. Once we bring him down, I promise, I will have his head.
You do not understand. Alduin cannot be slain like a lesser dragon. He is beyond our strength. Which is why I brought the Elder Scroll.
Feldir, we agreed not to use it.
I never agreed. And if you are right,
no,
I will not need it.
We will deal with Alduin ourselves. Hear it now.
We shall see soon enough. Alduin approaches.
So be it.
Me. Talmudis. Ah, me. Him hind parliv. Zuhindan.
Let those that watch from Savengard envy us this day.
Did it?
Yes. The World Eater is gone. May the spirits have mercy on our souls.
Join me.
did you come from?
Where'd you come from?
Lost foot! You are too late, Alduin! Dovahkiin, use Dragonrend if you know it!
Thank you.
What the fuck's going on? Why it flies so slow? Yeah, I know. But I miss.
I cannot be slain here.
Must be gone now.
Or anyone else.
Must be gone now.